right, I'm going to ask my new friend Chloe Arvin to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So welcome, everybody, to the January meeting of the Board of Education. I think we have the entire student body from South High School here for our showcase. We are very excited to welcome you, but first, we'd like to take care of some recognition. Superintendent?
All right, so one of the favorite times of the evening for myself is when we get to recognize outstanding individuals. So we're going to start off with the five people sitting to my right. This is the Board of Education Appreciation Month. Being a board member is probably one of the most thankless yet important jobs a community member can do to help our schools succeed. Oldham County Board of Education members, elected by the people, are responsible for Oldham County's most precious resource and the key to our future, our children, and their educational opportunities. They spend hours in workshops and reviewing documents to ensure our students are getting the best education. Thanks to the board, we now have nurses and school security officers on every campus. Each month, our board does a tremendous amount of work, from approving the school calendar, deciding a tax rate, rebalancing schools, reviewing academics, and discussing innovations, all to ensure that Oldham County Schools is a great place to learn and work. We are grateful for the leadership and engagement of our board members, Board Chair Dorsey Fletcher, Vice Chair Kevin Loosley, and members Walt Chum, Larry Dotson, and Patrick Kehoe. Oldham County Schools continues to lead our state in academic performance and innovative programs, and this type of leadership would not be possible without the wonderful support of our school board. So personally and professionally, I'd like to thank you. We couldn't do this without you. In that, at no taxpayer expense, this comes out of my purse, but I do have the privilege, I always like to make sure that people know that it's not me. I've worked with boards that are not as functional as this board, and it's truly my honor to call you all both my boss as well as my colleagues. So I have a little something for each of you. Ms. Fletcher, this is yours. Mr. Weasley? Dotson? Mr. Chum?
Well done, Super.
And Mr. Kehoe?
Personally, we'll find us something to eat.
Right.
Thank you all. I know that I speak for this entire board in saying that this is a pleasure to work, and we appreciate all of your support. Thank you.
Next up. The second part, we always know that we have fun when I do recognitions with student names because I usually butcher them. So I found a way around that tonight. I'm going to invite Dennis Ray, the OCBE president, to step to the podium and talk to us a little bit about the Pyramid Awards and do some recognitions.
Welcome, Mr. Ray.
Thank you. As Greg said, my name is Dennis Ray, and I'm the president this year of the Oldham County Educational Foundation. Thank you for allowing us to be here tonight, and especially to honor our newest Pyramid Award winners. The Oldham County Educational Foundation began in 1989 with the mission of raising money from community sources to supplement underfunded initiatives in our school district. To illustrate how far we've come, one of our early projects was putting a computer in every classroom. In the years since, we have supported the Arts Center, the Gifted and Talented Education Programs, Preschool, Early Literacy, and the Engineering Academy in this very building. A program that we have sustained since the humble beginnings of our foundation is the Pyramid Awards. These are individual grants of up to $1,000 that are competitively awarded to the most innovative classroom projects each year. The teachers file an application, we do a blind assessment, and we select the best projects. This year we had more than 70 applications, which is a record, and we're awarding 36 awards tonight, which is also a record. Our foundation board believes strongly that innovation will maintain Oldham County as one of the best school districts in the state. The educators who have these innovative ideas should have the resources to make that a reality. Our mission is to elevate the educational experience of Oldham County School students. Excellent teachers are key to accomplishing that mission. Tonight, we're pleased to honor several recipients with the Pyramid Awards, who will add to our total of over $400,000 that we have awarded in 30-year history. We're especially pleased to honor them in front of their families, their peers, the Board of Education, and distinguished guests from the community. We want to highlight the brilliant work they are doing and to celebrate them. We hope that when the time is right for you, you will support our foundation so that we may perpetuate innovation and excellence in Oldham County Public Schools. I should mention that the Head Trust has been a strong contributor over the years and really makes the Pyramid Awards, makes them go. This time, I'd like to begin to announce our winners. As I call your name, would you please walk up to receive your award and then head over to Mr. Schultz for a picture. Bill, can you help? We have several board members here tonight.
Let's recognize them, Mr. Gray.
Okay.
If you would, let's ask the board members if there are other Education Foundation board members that are with us tonight. I would like to thank them on behalf of the school board. And it looks like you two are representing tonight.
Okay. Well, we have more.
Oh, thank you all for being here.
So I'm going to try to do this by building. From the Arvin Education Center, Joan Laxton, You're So Vain. Jessica Miller, Art with Purpose. Say that after we present these awards this evening, we're going to have a little reception in the lobby for the winners and their families, and so the recognition will continue. Camden Station Elementary, Dana Moore, Engaging Math for All Learners, Allison No, TALONS Coding Club. Centerfield Elementary, Mallory Davis, High Impact Tools for Reading and Writing Instruction. Aaron King, Multicolored Masterpiece. Megan Goodwin, Engaging the 21st Century Learner. And Nicole, help me with this.
Chapman,
thank you. Virtual Reality, Where the Learning Engages All.
Sure, I'll do it.
It's sharp.
Beautiful. Okay. Thank you. Thank Thank you.
I shall be.
Crestwood Elementary, Nancy Robertson, bringing learning to life with VR.
It's a little bit more impressive. Let's do one more.
She's whispering about you over there.
She's also photobombing.
East Oldham Middle School, Amy Geisling, diving into drama, Jacqueline Green, programming patriots, Connie Morrison, enhancing learning through technology. Goshen Elementary, Felicia Claus, I steam, you steam, we all scream for steam. Brooke Wiseman, Wiseman's wonderful world of writers, a multi-sensory approach.
I'm the photo prop. This is the photo pop. I'll hold that. Here, Jamie, you hold that.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Thank you.
Harmony Elementary, Nancy Farmer, expanding the schema of emergent readers through nonfiction texts. Sherry Tabor, B-Bots.
So this is the same one?
That's Nancy.
Okay. Are you? I'm your son. Okay.
Congratulations.
All right, one of you hold the, let's hold the box and you hold the sample. The picture here. We're all popping here. This is like that.
Okay.
There you go.
All right, Joyce, smile.
Okay. Thank you. Kenwood Station Elementary, Lori Zabo, learning through visual collaboration. We will make sure Lori gets her pyramid. LaGrange Elementary, Kristen Arvin, enriching guided reading. Amber DeWitt, building social and emotional confidence in the school setting. Bethany Mater, Safe Place, creating classroom emotional regulation centers.
Congratulations. All right, don't open the box, just let me hold that and we'll hold the box. There you go. You're getting a Let's get to the slides.
There we go.
That's okay. That was a bit more of a picture.
I thought after his head floating in the back.
I don't know where to go, Heather.
Locust Grove Elementary, Sarah Hare, non-readers turned authors, giving students with learning disabilities the confidence to read, write, and share their creativity with others. North Oldham Middle School, Morgan W. Roberts, flexible seating for high school students, Elaine Dillard, Out of This World Robotics, Sarah Chris, The Drawing Robot, Kelly Fiorini, Discovering Dystopia, Allison Steinecker, Science Olympiad Resources. Oldham County High School, Alan Davis, Saturday Service, Brooke Paisley, flexible seating in the secondary classroom, Leslie Newport, modeling the flow of genetic information, Megan Cronin, stop the bleed. County Preschool, Karen Putlack, Read With Me, Bringing Books to Life. South Oldham High School, Charles Bentley, Wireless Investigation System for Engineering, nickname WISE. Colleen Davis, The Testing Effect in Action. Justin Romney, Facilitating Musical Learning for Persons with Special Needs. And Nixby Slider, Assessing the Art of Cooking, Life Skills for Students with Moderate to Severe Disabilities.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So just want to thank everybody for attending. There are two other parts to the award. One is a certificate, and we will have the certificate sent to the schools for each of the winners. And the other one's a check. And I hope the checks have already been distributed. So thanks, everybody.
We want to thank Mr. Ray again for his leadership of the Education Foundation. It's a wonderful support service to the school district, and we appreciate everybody's service on that foundation committee. You guys have done an amazing job over the last several years, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
Recipients, congratulations. This is really an honor to receive a Pyramid Award, but we also celebrate the fact that you are doing some really interesting and innovative things in your classrooms, and hopefully they will impact not just this group of students, but students in the future. And so we thank you so much for going, I think, above and beyond what your typical day might look like. So thank you so much. I would ask that you stay for a few minutes because you guys are really going to enjoy the student showcase. And then I'll give you an opportunity to slide out. Anything to add, Superintendent?
No, besides the fact that I've been in many of their classrooms and they are all-stars. It's tremendous fun for me to go in and see some of the neat stuff that they're doing, whether they're blowing stuff up or making music or whatever they're doing. It's always good stuff.
Let's thank them again one more time. Somewhere, Ms. Ray. Welcome. We are so excited about our student showcase this evening.
Well, thank you. We're excited. I think you can tell from the lobby and all the artwork we have out here. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Melissa Loosley. I'm principal of South Oldham High School. I am also a former graduate of South Oldham High School. And I have always taken great pride in being a Dragon. In August, when I saw on the calendar that this was going to be my year for showcase, I was really excited because I knew exactly who I wanted to showcase. So personally, as a student at South, the arts program was a place that I tapped in as a kid. So that automatically, I knew from there that that's who we wanted to showcase tonight. So thank you for allowing us to shine a light on some very wonderful and talented South students in our arts program. So this is all the talking I'm going to do because we have some fantastic professionals here that want to talk about their kids, and we have kids that are here to perform. So first up, back up here, Justin Romney, our choir director. He's going to introduce Dragon Beat.
Thank you, Ms. Woosley. Welcome, Mr. Romney.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure and an honor for us to perform for you tonight. This is Dragon Beat. They are an all-auditioned ensemble. It's mostly juniors and seniors. We do have a sophomore in the group this year, though. And we're getting close to Valentine's Day, so we thought we'd sing you a sweet little love song by Daniel Caesar. It's arranged by Brian Sharp, and this is Dragon Beat.
You don't know when you We all connect in a way. We all, we at least act like we get along. I mean, we usually do. And you, there's auditions, there's everything like that. But, you know, no one's a bad sport if they don't get in or whatever choir they're put into. And so, we're a nice, tight-knit community here in the choir department. Even in, we have people that are in the drama department, some people I know an aide in my fifth period class, which is helping with the special needs kids, that she does band, but she's also doing the choir with the special needs kids, which is an honor to do, that I get to do that, and see how they grow, and see how their community is growing closer together, and how they get to express themselves through this department, and through the choir department, you can just express yourself in a way that you can't in, saying you're taking the antiderivative of a function,
I understand.
It gives you it also gives you a way of, to escape all the stress you have in other classes. You can get, a bunch of anger out in, an angry song, or you can just sing about love like we just did, and so... That's really all I have to say.
Thank you, Ms. Anna. You said it beautifully. And I think it must be a great honor to be successful in the Dragon Beat, and first of all, to be selected, and then to be able to sing a cappella. And so I really have a lot of, as a person who cannot carry a tune, I'm very envious, and I applaud you all. I hope you will pursue your music careers.
Good evening. My name is Heather Duffy, and I'm the newest member of the arts team at South Oldham High School. I have the joy and pleasure of teaching our general arts classes, as well as painting and drawing. And we have some wonderful students here representing our visual arts tonight. I know that in the audience, I've seen Emma Laird, and Isaac Lolly, Chloe Irvin, and Ashley Watkins, Sarah Burbank,
Chloe Arvin. Could I get my art students to stand if you're in the visual arts? Let me give them a round of applause.
Yes.
So in addition to general art at South Oldham, we have the joy of offering painting and drawing and sculpture, jewelry making, 3D design, photography, so our students can grow. And ultimately, they can take an AP course in visual arts as well. Tonight, I have the joy of introducing a student to speak to you. Her name is Ms. Sarah Burbank, and she's going to talk to you about what the arts has meant to her.
Thank you, Ms. Duffy.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello. I'd first like to thank Mrs. Duffy for giving me the opportunity to speak tonight, as well as members of the school board for serving our district. The importance of the arts in academic, personal, and creative development is hard to overstate. Schools that add fine arts programs to their curriculum consistently see improved test scores and graduation rates. Experience in visual arts during childhood development has been proven to improve emotional intelligence, motor skills, and problem-solving abilities. Experimentation in the form of fine arts lends itself to a sense of accomplishment and serves as a vital outlet of emotional and creative expression often lacking during adolescence. Art can serve as therapy or simply a pastime for anyone who endeavors to learn. It is a form of expression uniquely unbounded by age, wealth, or even skill. Anyone who chooses to can experience its benefits. For me personally, visual arts, and specifically portraiture, has served as a way to physically manifest my perceptions of beauty, as well as a tactile way to conceptualize my understanding of my own self-image and the question of what truly gives one worth. By viewing the world with an appreciation for detail and broader shape, I have been able to find joy in bleakness and happiness in simplicity. I owe much of my appreciation to the arts to my public education. In fact, my mother was an art teacher for several years. Since I was in kindergarten, various art teachers have gone to great pains to demonstrate to my peers and I the emotional and technical efforts that go into the creation of a masterpiece. And while we may not have always appreciated the finer points of Picasso's technique or Beethoven's Fifth, this fostered an appreciation for life's grander points and pursuits in all of us. By being exposed to masters of sensory expression and seeking to similarly express our own creative musings, we were all allowed to view ourselves as people with the potential to develop our intellectual pursuits, as well as individuals that had the ability to create and take initiative for our own passions. I assuredly would not possess the self-confidence or autonomy that I do today were it not for the influence of the arts in my life. And it is for this reason that I'm so thankful to live in a school district which so greatly values artistic pursuits both in and out of schools. And I thank those who are continuing to work, who are working to continue this legacy on behalf of the many people that have been impacted by this kind of great art program. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Are you responsible for all of that, Sarah? You did a great job. I do want to say, just on behalf of this board, that we do support the arts in this district. There have been times when finances have been very, very challenging in this school district, and we have never allowed the arts in any of our schools to suffer. We have always made sure that each of our schools had art teachers, music teachers, PE teachers, and drama teachers, and so music teachers. But at any rate, so I do thank you for recognizing that, and we recognize that. So thank you, Ms. Sarah.
Hello, I am Chandra Holloway Emerson, and first of all, I just want to thank Melissa Woosley and the administrative staff at South Oldham High School for their continued support of the arts. We can always go there when we need money, and they have a can-do kind of spirit, and we really appreciate that. It is a great honor to be able to teach in the arts at South Oldham. I also want to thank the Board of Education and Superintendent Schultz for believing in the arts and allowing us to thrive. I was in the Oldham County Marching Band back in yes, that's right, and went through the arts programs there, and Dr. Arvin was one of the people who started that, and we appreciate the legacy that you all continue on here, and Oldham County is a great place for the arts. I also want to recognize Heather Duffy again for organizing this. She spearheaded it. I mean, Melissa wanted us to showcase that, and you know, Heather kind of took it on to get us all organized, so thank you very much on that, too. I'm really delighted to introduce one of the most talented and hardworking students I've had the pleasure to know and work with, they will make Oldham County proud. Alex Capriolio.
Sit it right.
Hello, my name is Alex Capriolio. I'm a senior, and I've been in Ms. Emerson's class 3 times. I've been doing art since I was a little child. I've been doing art basically for like 3 hours every day since as long as I can remember, whether it's writing, practicing ukulele, or doing some kind of illustration. I've done a lot of art classes, and over time, they became really monotonous. It felt like I wasn't getting the stimulation I needed, and generally, I kind of felt like my creative flow was being cut off simply by the expectations and limitations of guidelines. With creative literacies, we were introduced to new mediums and experiences that differed from the repetitive motions of traditional art classes. It was a fun environment where even kids that I knew who were more of the athletic type or didn't believe they had any creative talent or artistic felt that they had an artistic inability were able to find something fun or something that they could channel their inspiration or their thoughts and actions into and find that they did have an artistic side. With the Integrity Project, a graffiti-based contest that was done on paper in the classroom, Ms. Emerson scheduled with Ivan Preciado of Street Art Throwdown and Walking Giants Company. We were able to practice this typically taboo form of art in an environment that didn't come with all the connotations that typically have parents against it. I was one of the winners, and I honestly felt that it was a really fun and unique way because we were able to express ourselves and our own ideas and experiment in a way that usually, even in creative literacies, we didn't quite do because it pushed people to try new things. Creative literacies has often allowed me and my peers to test the waters in ways that we wouldn't on our own, and for that I can only say that it's a very valuable class that I would take again every time that it's offered to me. And I hope that it inspires more kids to unleash the artists that they have in their hearts and minds. Thank you.
Ms. Alex, are there examples of your work out here?
I wasn't aware that I was going to be presenting any art tonight, but I think there's a few pieces from when I was in creative literacies and we were watching Face Off on the slideshow out there.
Where can we actually go?
Well,
in this city to see your...
You could look online. I have an Instagram account where I post art regularly.
Yeah, Creative Literacies Instagram account too.
Yeah,
Creative
Literacies. There's a couple pieces of that on the Creative Literacies account, but I usually do it on my personal account, and I have a Redbubble store where I sell pieces of my art as merchandise. But otherwise,
right.
I don't think there's many places where I post it.
Okay. Just please tell me you're not hanging from the bridges.
No.
All right. Thank you for sharing. Excellent.
Ryan McAllister, he's going to close it out, and then an Urban will be up to talk. So with that legacy, we will have her speak.
Thank you. Hello.
Well, thank you. Ryan McAllister, band director at South Oldham High School. We have around 120 students in the band program and 4 different classes that we have, and we couldn't bring them all here tonight, but we brought a few select students to perform for you. I want to recognize the few students we have in the back here that performed before the meeting out in the lobby. We have Brass Quintet and the Sax Quartet. Would you guys stand
they
up?
They were awesome.
To close out, we have 2 of our students that were All-State students that are going to be performing with the KMEA All-State band next week. They're going to play a little duet for you, Chloe Arvin and Shelby Ross.
Thank you.
Chloe Arvin was going to say a few words. She is involved in both our art program and the band program. She's going to say a few words.
Thank you, ladies. That was beautiful. Chloe, welcome.
Thank you. The art programs at South have always been a great funnel for creativity because most of the academic classes, they always have to follow like Common Core and national standards. So there's not a whole lot of deviation to get to express yourself and try new things that like don't need to fit a strict criteria. And because of this, there's a great broad range of opportunity in all the arts programs that really gives anybody, like everyone has something they can enjoy. It's not like you're good at math or you're not. You can always find something in the arts program that's wonderful, which really allows everybody involved to branch out and meet like new people from different backgrounds that they're not used to. Because I'm in a lot of AP and advanced classes, and while that's great, I feel like I don't get to meet like a broad range of people because it's a lot of the same personalities and types of people. Whereas in the arts, you can meet people from like all backgrounds, and they're all like everybody's different and unique. And it's really great to get to meet them because when you get to like meet new people, different people, then you really get to learn to view your own life objectively. And it's really helped me like take on new perspectives and understand other people and have a lot more compassion and empathy in that respect. Arts, they've also strengthened my work ethic a lot because I complete it because I have personal enjoyment from it and not just trying to maintain a GPA or something like that. And so because of this, it's really strengthened my sense of intrinsic motivation and actually accomplishing things to make myself happy and not just for a reward. And so this really helps motivate me to get a lot more done. And one of the great motivators and encouragers of like the arts is that there's really visible improvement over the years. Like, if you look at your math classes, it's like a different math class every year, so you can't see how much you've improved. But if I listen to an audition tape from a year or two ago, or look at an old art piece, then I can see visible improvement, which encourages me to continue to improve. One of the things about the arts that some people see as a weakness is a lot of arts classes are considered easy A's, but I really think this is a great strength of the art because they don't need to hold a grade over someone's head to get them to work. People work because they want to, and they don't have to deal with the stress of having to get that difficult A. So I think when teachers or classes say, it's going to be tough to get an A in this class, that means it's a good class, I think that's really false because students should be able to learn without having to struggle. Like, they should be able to enjoy their learning. Because learning is a lot more effective when the students are actually invested in enjoying that. And so when students are interested in the arts, that's why it's so effective in getting them to learn and be motivated. The arts helped me to learn to express myself because most classes, you don't really get to be expressive. Like Anna was talking about how in math, how are you supposed to express yourself in derivatives? You can't do that. And so getting to express yourself, it really does help you become more, like you get to know your emotional self and understand like what you're going through. So because of the arts, I believe I've become a lot more confident, motivated, and determined to succeed, which is a wonderful thing to have in life. And because of this, I'm capable of accomplishing a lot more than I thought I ever could. Because a year or two ago, I never thought I'd be able to make Allstate, but through like practice, I've learned that I was actually able to do it and that I should never underestimate myself. Because if I underestimate myself, I'm really just hurting myself, because then that's never possible to achieve those things. The arts have helped me find purpose and belonging, and I really hope that follows me into my next stage of life. Thank you. Wow.
Spokesperson. You did an excellent job, Chloe. Thank you so much for sharing. And what a great summary about the arts. Questions or comments, board members?
Very well. I have a quick comment,
Madam
Chair. This board has made an enormous contribution to funding of the arts in Oldham County through the Center for the Arts, but it's very rare that we get to see talent from each school individually. So I'd like to personally thank the teachers for slugging it out in the classroom and keeping the students going at a more local level, and also providing for the arts in the schools. We know much study has been done on the foundation of education, and those that have a background in the arts tend to succeed in secondary education as well as life. So it's very gratifying to see this amount of work going on at the school level. Thank you, Ms. Woosley, and thank you, teachers that take care of these students. It was a very, very good showcase.
Thank you, Mr. Much for sharing these fabulous students and staff members. Thank you for your investment in our most precious resource. I'm going to give everybody a few minutes to exit graciously, unless you'd like to stay for the rest of this exciting meeting.
Said we could go.
You gotta run camera, I'm leaving. Heather and I have a bag of margaritas, we gotta go.
Phase one tear-off is complete, and the weatherproofing ice and water shield has been installed. Note on that, I have held them off on proceeding to tear off any more roof until panels start to arrive and start to be in place there. So as soon as panels do arrive and they begin to replace the phase one roof, I'll let them go ahead and start tearing off phase two. Also included in your packet there is an update on the Oldham County High School partial roof replacement and foundation repairs. And I just want to point out, to draw your attention to the bottom of that report, which has an anticipated schedule that we're working towards to begin work this summer. Are there any questions?
Questions, board members? All right. Thank you, Mr. O'Hannon. Superintendent, report number two, please.
She is not a backup singer to anybody. Our own board attorney, Ms. Ann Corson, great. I'm going with RP.
Okay.
Thank you.
Could you put a sachet up the podium? We didn't have any dance representatives.
Well, give her my hands. Trying to tell us you're not our girl.
I'm sorry, I'm not your girl. You have the first read of our new suggested policy revisions. This is the first month. One thing you'll note is on 3010, which is the audit policy you all asked to have changed, allocating the cost from the schools back to the board would be effective upon adoption. So it will go into effect this year. So those funds will not be taken from the schools. The first policy revision has to do with open meetings, and you might be excited to find out you can video conference your board meetings now. So
nice.
Nice, huh? You all just go video and we'll sit here.
Ms. Courtney Corson. If one of us is not here, can they video conference in?
They can now video conference in.
And be considered present.
Mm-hmm. If you have to follow the procedures in the statute, but now they are allowing that, including closed sessions. The rest of the policies are pretty self-explanatory, the changes that we're suggesting. Do you have any questions about any of the suggested changes? Some of these you'll see are holdovers from the 2018 legislative session that we had to make changes.
I don't have any questions. Questions for me? All right, we will have a month to ponder these policies and take action next month.
Yes, you will.
Thank you, Ms. Corson. Superintendent, report number 3, sir.
She's not any money, but she talks about our money. I have a set answer to go up and get the feedback, but I'm kind of good.
The arts.
Yeah, you sure don't want me to perform
any artistic endeavors here.
Make this money disappear.
Not disappear, you save it.
You could ask her to dance.
No dance.
I've given up on that. All right, Ms. Anderson.
Yes.
What do you got for us?
The Kentucky Department of Education requires each local board of education to prepare and review a draft budget. This excludes multi-year funds for the next fiscal year no later than January 31st of the current fiscal year. This draft budget is prepared mainly for compliance purposes and provides budget information based on the current year operations and some fiscal 20 projected expenditures. As such, the draft budget is not a fully developed budget and should be reviewed as a basis for beginning discussions related to the preparation of the tentative and working budgets for fiscal 20. The draft budget reflects revenues currently exclusive of on-behalf revenue of $85.097 million, recurring expenditures of $85.252 million, and a contingency of $15.163 million, which is 17.8%. Some of the costs that we've identified being changes compared to fiscal 18 are listed below. We are not considering increases in revenue at this time based on our current knowledge of property assessment quadrants and the student enrollment. We are considering various options for merit type salary increases. Those are listed below, just some of the things that we have talked about. We are going to incur another year of 12% increase in the CERS costs. That will bring it to a grand total of 24.06%, and I believe they probably have another couple, 3 years before we get to the final rate that they had anticipated stopping at. Additional costs that we're looking at right now are some staffing for an art chair in the Gates Department and some mental health at $220,000. We're also looking at some IT staffing at $110,000. Additional IT infrastructure upgrades of about $800,000, an interactive classroom refresh of also of $800,000, and the APQC process management services about $15,000. We are also looking at further ways to reduce the contingency. That would include 6 buses rather than the 3 that we have done in the past, out of contingency at $660,000. And we're also looking at some construction projects to include 2 band towers, the center field playground and drainage issues, and center field office renovations.
Can I ask a question about center field?
Yeah.
We just renovated that building. Why do we need to renovate the offices again?
There are certain parts of that building that remained and they were untouched basically to save money during that renovation project. If you remember the time frame where we were financially with that, there was a lot of things that were left as they were in the school. Basically in the office area, there's some cabinetry work that was left remaining from whenever it was previously installed. So there's a lot of things that are outdated in portions of that building. You remember after the construction was concluded and that after we closed out, we came back afterwards and added a project to replace the windows. That was something else that was value engineered out of the original construction project, but kind of added, you know, left to do in future date.
Okay. Thanks, Brett.
On the next page, I outlined the dollar amounts in the various funds that total up to $152.894 million. Our recommendation is to review the draft budget in preparation for discussions related to the completion of the tentative budget and direct the superintendent to continue to revise these budget estimates. And the budget does follow on that next page in a very tentative form.
Right. Thank you. We've had several conversations about this. Part of our board retreat centered around the budget, so we appreciate this, Ms. Anderson. Are there any questions at this time? This is a superintendent report, so we'll take a look at this again.
No, besides that, you know, this time of year, as you all know, you all are very experienced on the board. This is throwing stuff on the wall to see what's going to stick as we work through the monetary situation and then make adjustments as needed.
Right. All right, thank you, Ms. Anderson.
Thank you.
Mr. Schultz, we have two action items, sir. Action item G.
Okay, I'll set them up. There we go. At the board regular meeting in December, you provided a draft schedule of 2019 regular board meetings, and so asking for you to approve those meeting schedules as submitted.
We have had an opportunity to review these dates. Are there any additional comments, board members? Recommendations, Superintendent?
Approve the 2019-20 board meeting schedule as submitted.
Motion to approve made by Mr. Dodson and seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor? 5-0. Thank you all. Action item H, sir.
We have a approval for a student request for early graduation, and the details are provided within your packet.
Yes, they are. Any questions about this, board members? So your recommendation, sir?
Approve the early graduation due to hardship for South Oldham High School student as submitted.
Motion to approve, made by Mr. Shum and seconded by Mr. Kehoe. All those in favor, and that's 5-0. Thank you all. Mr. Williams? Would somebody mind knocking on the glass?
I
got
it.
Oh, I wanted
to see him
right.
Just waiting for another joke.
You were going to get my cookie.
Check your out. That's it.
No public expression. Imagine that. All right. Board members, you have two information items for your review. One is the monthly preschool report, and the other is the monthly district energy report. Superintendent, what is your recommendation, sir?
Make a recommendation to adjourn.
Thank you. Motion to adjourn made by Mr. Dodson and seconded by Mr. Woosley. All those in favor? 5-0. Thank you. Safe travels.